I believe we have exactly the same situation we had a few years ago when there was a class action lawsuit against cigarette companies. The cigarette companies knew a long time ago that cigarettes were addictive and that they caused lung cancer, and they had memos circulating internally that that pointed that out. Now the polluters, the carbon polluters, have proven to have had 14 years ago memos circulating internally based on their own evidence that carbon dioxide was causing global warming and that it was man-made emissions that were increasing the amount of carbon dioxide in the atmosphere. They knew that their businesses were causing global warming, and they could have known by the reports of the International Panel of Climate Change, which were existing then, because it's only a decade ago, that activity was ultimately detrimental, even murderous, to the world's citizens, not only their businesses, but just everybody around the world. And the fact that after that happened, after they have had made the decision to, first of all, ignore that information, second of all, lobby actively by giving misinformation in the press, in the media, trying to skew public opinion away from believing that global warming might be a problem or that man might be the cause of global warming, they also called large subsidies for building SUVs, which were just too heavy or more heavy than they had to be able to get that SUVs. So basically, US citizens have been completely robbed and deceived in the most criminal way. It's just mind-boggling to me. And if it's of course not only the car companies, but the other polluters as well. They came together and they tried to find out what was the truth about it. And then they covered it up. I guess if nothing is done now, this will amount to mass murder on a global scale, because it will basically have 14 years of complete loss of action against climate change. Because if they 14 years ago had been on the side of the International Panel for Climate Change, they would have taken action, or they would have had taken action. In the meantime, the oil companies had made billions and billions and billions and billions of profits. And all that money went somewhere, I guess, in the real estate, other kinds of all kinds of projects that use oil, usually, because they're driving their own business. Now, if you have a class action lawsuit of the US citizen against these companies, based on the memos that have circulated themselves internally, based on the fact that some time ago, of course, CO2 was considered a pollutant, and of course, counting into the whole information availability, the lobbies that they have had started in the past to cover up and to make it. For instance, if you have a lobby of somebody saying that carbon dioxide is a pollutant and should not be emitted in the atmosphere just like that, but you have a car company or another company that has a lobby against that decision, a paid lobby, while they already know that what you say is true, how criminal is that? So what I would suggest is that some lawyer, and I would be very interested to know about who wants to pick it up, because it's easy, it's a slam dunk. And what you can do after that is take all the profits. You don't have to ruin the business of the oil companies right away. That would be ruinous to the US citizen as well. But take all their profits, which are still significant, and put all their profits into alternative energy. And don't allow them to develop new oil, new sources of oil, tar sands, whatever. Because they are investing millions and millions and millions in those type of technologies, while if they would invest similar amounts, for instance, and it's my hobby horse, but seaweed, which is extremely cheap to start up as a source of ethanol, fertilizer, food, biofuel, you would be done in a few years. You would be done in about 5 years with providing people with fuel. But of course, that activity is also suppressed. So start a class action lawsuit. And it's just a slam dunk, and it will benefit everybody. And everybody that says now, you know, it's not really necessary, so they can look up the memos of these companies themselves, in which they say it is a problem, it is caused by humans, by us, and we're not going to do anything about it. Are you going to do something about it? I hope you do.